Hello everyone! Believe it or not, Magnus Carlsen is having a great tournament. That's something no one in the world said in quite a while. It's the Isle of Man Open International Tournament, and after six rounds, Carlsen is holding the first place with 5.5 out of 6 points. And this was round six. He was playing with the black pieces against the Ukrainian Grandmaster Pavel Elyanov. And even though Pavel actually has a terrible score against Carlsen, in classical games they played six games. Carlsen won all six, and in rapid, I think they played five games or six maybe. Carlsen won four, Elyanov won only one, and I think they have one draw. So definitely a score in Carlsen's favor, but Elyanov always goes for him, despite his very negative score. So definitely not discouraged by this. And I do enjoy that, well, Carlsen plays an opening. I often play in blitz games and bullet games and well, also in hyperbullet games. It's a fun opening to play. But I've never actually seen it played on such a high level. So it was very interesting for me. We have knight to f3 by Elyanov, b6, and now e4. And okay, although I usually play b6 when someone plays e4, but they transposed into the same opening. But probably Carlsen wouldn't go for b6 if Elyanov opened with e4. But nevertheless, bishop to b7, knight to c3, we have e6 preparing to go for bishop to b4. We have d4, bishop to b4 now, bishop to d3, knight to f6, so going for this e4 pawn. Queen to e2, now defending it, and d5. And I had this position in like 100 games, and well, my opponents usually push e5 here. But Elyanov captures the d5 pawn. We have e captures on d5, and now queen captures on d5, as the knight is still pinned. Elyanov castles, and we have bishop captures on c3, b captures on c3, and knight b to d7. And okay, white has a doubled c pawn, but he also does have the bishop pair. Now, he does have to use it wisely. Elyanov plays c4, kicking the queen. We have queen to h6, and we have bishop to f4, going for that c7 pawn. Rook to c8 defending, and pawn to a4. We have pawn to a5, and rook 8 to b1. The idea is rook to b5, going for that queen on h5. Carlsen castles, and we have rook to b5 now. We have c5, blocking this attack on the queen. And, well, Carlsen said that Elyanov is better here. And with a move like c3, or for example, bishop to d6, that this would have been good for white. But Elyanov went for the early d captures on c5. We have rook captures on c5, and now Elyanov plays bishop to d6. It seems like he's attacking both rooks. But, well, this doesn't really do anything, as rook captures on b5. We have c captures on b5, and now rook to c8. We have c4, and now knight to c5. And here he's attacking this bishop on d3. Of course, Carlsen would enjoy exchanging his knight for this bishop, eliminating white's bishop pair. But Elyanov doesn't allow this. We have bishop to c2, and now knight c to e4. Again, going for a bishop here on d6, and offering the exchange of knights here. I mean, bishop for a knight here, if Elyanov would agree. But of course, he doesn't. We have bishop to f4. And now knight to c3, attacking the queen, and also adding pressure to this a4 pawn. Queen to d3, and now Carlsen plays queen to g4. Now with some nasty ideas of bishop captures on f3, this f4 bishop is attacked. And, well, can Elyanov capture this knight on c3? Well, he can, but this forcefully loses a pawn. For example, queen captures on c3, queen captures on f4. For example, knight e5, not allowing bishop captures on f3. Knight to g4, now threatening checkmate. Knight captures, queen captures. Now Carlsen would be threatening checkmate here on g2. And after f3 is simply queen captures on c4. It's, well, six pawns against five. And, well, this would have been an easy game for Carlsen, as the bishops are of the same color. So after queen to g4... Elyanov decided to give up a pawn in a different way. He played bishop to e5 immediately. And Carlsen captures the pawn. Queen captures on c4. We have queen captures on c4, rook captures on c4. And now Carlsen, of course, is attacking this a4 pawn twice. We have bishop to d3. Now attacking the rook. Rook goes to c8. Of course, the rook cannot capture, as this knight would be hanging on c3. Rook to a1, now adding more defense to the a4 pawn. Knight f to d5 is coming. Knight to d2. And now we have f6, kicking the bishop away from e5. Bishop to d6. And now knight to b4, attacking the bishop on d3. We have bishop to c4. And now bishop to d5, offering the exchange of bishops. We have bishop to f1 by Elianov. And now Carlsen plays knight b to a2. And in this position, Elianov resigned the game. So this is move 29. It's a below 30 move game. Very nice performance by Carlsen. As well, there is no defense against capturing this a4 pawn. Soon the b5 pawn is falling as well. And this is, well, completely winning for black. Elianov isn't interested in playing this game anymore. So yeah, it was a very interesting game. Even though Elianov had the bishop pair for the entire game, the two bishops never actually found any coordination. So Carlsen's knights really did the job here. So yeah, that's the game. There are three more rounds in the Isle of Man international tournaments. We'll see how Carlsen will fare in the last three rounds. And well, hopefully he can maintain his number one place in the world. We'll see. So yeah, that's the game. I do hope you enjoyed it. As usual, you can check two of my previous videos here. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you soon.